إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ليس لنا رب سواه ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين يقول المولى عز وجل في كتابه العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد my dear brothers and sisters in Islam إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, together we need to find out why the curve of the moral, the akhlaq of the Muslims going down. Why our akhlaq is not matching the akhlaq that we learn it from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And why the akhlaq is most important part in the Islam. The Islam equal the moral, equal the akhlaq. If you have no akhlaq, you have no Islam. And you, if you are Muslim and you don't have akhlaq, you cannot be a Muslim. So we need to think together how we return our akhlaq back as a Muslims. To deal with each other with the akhlaq. To understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He loves the people who has akhlaq. It's very important for all of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's mentioned to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that He has the most moral, the best, the highest. وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ You have the high moral, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before the Islam, they have a servant, they have people work for them, they treat them like an animal. Until the Islam arrived and the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam received the Quran from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Jibreel alayhi salam, and he make everyone is equal. Bilal, Mu'adhin Rasulillah, he is the most one who get hurt. And when the Islam came, he became one of the famous person who calling the adhan. And he's going to be the highest neck on the Jannah. That's how is the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to take it part by part. The akhlaq of the Muslim cannot be changed unless you change it by your own akhlaq, personal. So we have to think about ourselves, individual. See what we are doing from our time we wake up in the morning until the time we sleep. How is our akhlaq? Our akhlaq is going on. Why we let everything go and we let the akhlaq behind because of our business? Personal, if you have akhlaq, akhlaq the Islam, the moral of the Islam, you will feel comfortable by yourself. You will feel happy. You're going to see what you are doing, that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking you for it. Then you will be happy. Personal, you see yourself a very good person. Change in your life because you cannot deal with something else unless what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you for it. So your akhlaq, when you walk in the earth, it's the most important thing. So you carry the akhlaq to your home. And everybody see how honest you are. Take the ayah from Surah As-Saff and build your akhlaq on this ayah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Now He's talking to the believer. هل أدلكم على تجارة تنجيكم من عذاب أليم? Do you need a business from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save you from the hellfire? تؤمنون بالله ورسوله. First thing, the iman, because the taqwa and iman is akhlaq. If you have taqwa, you have iman, you have akhlaq, the jannah is for you. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the person who has akhlaq, I can guarantee the jannah for him. And the people who is pushing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who is taking care of the orphan, and the people who has highest akhlaq, moral. هل أدلكم على تجارة تنجيكم من عذاب أليم تؤمنون بالله ورسوله وتجاهدون في سبيل الله بأموالكم وأنفسكم ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون يغفر لكم ذنوبكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار ومساكن طيبة في جنات عدن ذلك الفوز العظيم وأخرى تحبونها نصر من الله وفتح قريب وبشر المؤمنين. So he's talking to the believers. You have to have business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So myself and yourself, we have to check what we have to do. Our salah is very important. If you do your salah and you have no akhlaq, your salah is unacceptable. If you pay your zakah and your sadaqah and you have no akhlaq, your salah and your zakah is not acceptable. So why? There is a jannah and the hellfire wal'iyadu billah. You need to enter the jannah, you have to have akhlaq. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the most beautiful example for us. How he's dealing with his family, how he was dealing with his wives. And the hadith that Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, كان أكثركم حبا للأولاد. And he said لأولاده. When you say to his child, he's talking about the general of the child of the Sahaba and his grandkids. And how he was dealing with Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn. How is Akhlaq Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is getting closer to Aisha radiallahu anha wa arda, Umm Salama, and all the wives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And how he was dealing with the Sahaba. How is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, look at the people in the masjid and you know who's not there and who's not. Who is sick and he want to visit. How is his Akhlaq toward his Sahaba sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And next to him, he's right, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu arda. Sayyidina Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu arda, he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the people moved from Mecca to Medina, he is saying, Ta'am uthnain yakfi ila thalath. The food for two people can be good for three. Meaning, extend your hand for the people who's traveling, because they have place behind the masjid of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, taking care of the traveler. And we used to have that actually for all the Muslim countries and in the masajid. They have room for the guests. They can stay a day or two and they're taking care of it. It starts from the house of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam next to the masjid. Sayyidina Abu Bakr heard that. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I would take these three together. So he invited them to his house, radiallahu anhu arda. Then he spoke to his son, Abdul Rahman. He said, I have something to do with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just to feed your guest. They said over there, they waiting Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he didn't come. Sayyidina Abdul Rahman, he said, eat. They said, no, we cannot eat without Abu Bakr. So when he came back, he thought that his son didn't do his duty toward his guest. So he was mad to his son. See how is the hub, how is the akhlaq of the people. And he said, Ya Abu Bakr, we say that we cannot eat until you arrived and we can eat together. That's Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq. See how loved they are. But if you look at Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, if he has food in his house and no guest, he get mad. He said, Allah upset from me. See the akhlaq, even all the prophets. Because the akhlaq is the most important thing in our life. Sayyidina Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu arda, and his story with his mother, when she was cursing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he's asking the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make dua against his mother because she's cursing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he don't like that. But what happened to the akhlaq and the moral of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide Umm Abu Huraira to the Islam. The mother of Abu Huraira, when he went there, she was waiting for him to make a wudu and she gave the shahada. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his way, he saw an old woman. She carried a lot of heavy stuff. He asked her for help. She said, I ask people, they don't want it. You're gonna help? And he helped sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He carried the stuff to her house. And she said, I don't have enough money to give you. Oh man, oh son, listen, I'll give you one advice. He said, give it to me. She said to him, there is a man, they call him Muhammad. He come with the deen, he's a majis. He's not a really prophet. Don't listen to him. And he look at her, say, even this man is me, I am Muhammad. She look at him, she say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa annaka ya Muhammadun Rasulullah. This is the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu arda, and when we talk about Umar, we talk about the man, he used the power for everything. If you not straight it for the deen of Allah, he used his power. But he's a very kind person. We have it in our life. If you are passing by someone and he hit you, and you are blind, you get mad. The man said the same thing to Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu arda. Are you blind? So the people around Sayyidina Umar, do you know who's Umar radiallahu anhu arda? Do you want to fight back? He says, stop. The man, he didn't say anything wrong. He's asking questions. See the akhlaq. He said, you are blind. And now I'm respond. No, I'm not a blind. Very easy and simple. In our time, we will fight. Fight back. Fight back because we don't understand our akhlaq. Where it will take us. You have to be calm and cool. That's what Sayyidina Abu Bakr all the time, when somebody negotiates, says something, you don't like it, it's not related to Islam, he has beautiful words from the Quran, wa'arid anil jahileen, stay away from the jahil. Because we learn from the scholars, if somebody talk about someone front of you, and you are listening to him, you are committed a sin with him. You have to give an excuse all the time. We learn from our a'imma, our scholars. And we have a witness. The person says something's really bad about the imam, front of us. And we say, be careful, imam. They say so and so. Before you continue, say, stop. Maybe he didn't mean it. Maybe he needs something else. Don't take it this way. Take it the positive way. See, they stop you from continue talking and backbiting. That was the real imam, the real Islam, by akhlaq of the Muslims who come and pray. Because again, we need to achieve the Jannah. Sayyidina Al-Hasan Al-Husayn, when they have an issue together, and he heard that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَخَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ يَبْدَأْ بِالسَّلَامِ, the best among you, the one who extended his hand first. So they said, Hassan, go and talk to Hussein. He said, no, let him come and talk to me. When it happened and he came and talked to him, why don't go? He said, because خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ يَبْدَأْ بِالسَّلَامِ, and I like him to get more reward from Allah than me. See how they love each other. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, the wealthy man, time when in Medina got decreased on all the products. And the qafila, the shipment came from Asham, from Syria to Al-Medina. And the business people all jumped to buy because there's nothing there. And they offer him some money. He didn't accept it. And he said, no, some people pay more. Some people pay more. Until the highest number, and they say, no, someone give me 10 times the amount of what I paid. They said, who he is? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what I have in this trip, it's for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the poor of the Medina. So they think about the Jannah. They don't think about themselves. Today we are Muslims, but we not practice Islam. Today we are Muslims and we don't have the akhlaq of the Islam. Today we are Muslims and we hate each other. Today we are Muslims and we've been divided together to fight among each other. Individual, inside the countries, inside the houses, everywhere Muslim fighting together because our own Islam hiding in our front head, Muslims, but no practice. We don't have akhlaq. How many of us can say, I'm really Muslim? I have the akhlaq of the Islam. Today in the family, see how many male and female fighting together, husband and wife fighting together. Family court, 40% for the Muslim country. 40% in the family court, which we don't have it before. More than 45% divorce in the Muslim countries than before. Before we have like 2-3% in Egypt. Today we have 45% divorced. Before, the one, if her husband died, very hard to get married. Today she can marry 3-4 times. Now we are getting business. We lift it. We lift the Islam. We don't carry our Islam anymore. Look at the people today, what they are wearing. Where is the akhlaq of the Islam? We just copy. We don't practice. We see what's going on today in Afghanistan. And we talk about Taliban, non-Taliban, whatever it is. Both parties, Muslims. Both parties, they pray. Both parties, la ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. They are afraid from each other. They fight among each other. It's one country only, we talk about it. Is this the Islam? How do you pray? Why do they kill each other? See the rahmah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the man inside the majlis, he urinate in the place they pray. And the sahaba tried to stand to stop him. He said, leave him alone, don't stop him. But after he finished, he said, just put some dirt and some sand on the top of it. And then he spoke to him individually. See the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he sees a man, he starts to pray and he's going fast, he call him. He says, salli fa innaka lam tusalli. Pray again. He didn't pray the right way. Go up and down the right way. Understand what you are saying. This is the mercy and love and the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when he comes to the masjid, we see the lady who's taking care of the masjid. She's not there. He's asking where she is. Said she died, Ya Rasulullah, and we buried her. He said, take me to her grave and I pray for her. Why didn't talk to me? See how is the love and mercy and kind and the akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he saw the janazas passing by and he stands sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Rasulullah, he's Jew. He's Jewish. What you are doing? He say, I'm upset. That's one of the people away from my hand to become a Muslim before he die. Where we add from this akhlaq? Where we add from Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu arda when he was passing by and he heard the lady, she was screaming and she's cursing Umar radiallahu anhu arda. He put his ear and ear and he wanted to listen what she is saying. And then he come closer to her and say, Ya Amatullah, why are you cursing Umar? She say, my kids are hungry and I don't have food. And he's in his place eating and they enjoy. He didn't say who I am. He went back and he carried the wheat in his shoulder until she cooked and she feed the kids and asked her by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. Who you are? He's Umar radiallahu anhu arda. The sahaba asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, if we are practiced so and so and so and so, the Jannah for us? He was smiling sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they say, Aktharukum akhlaqa. The best who has high moral, akhlaq. See, the akhlaq is very important. Because the akhlaq can guide you to everything good. We hear today the problem inside our houses. And the way does the child talk to the parents. And we carry it over to the people who marry and had kids, how they talk to their father as a grandfather at this time. With no respect. With no respect. High voice. They raise their voice. They talk very bad. They don't come when they talk to the parents. They sit down with them with unacceptable weight. While before, in long time, years ago, you scared to get closer to your grandfather. You scared not because you are afraid, of just for respect. It's a meaning of a grandfather in the house. It's a real meaning that I am here to talk to my father and my grandfather because they are there. to help and support. If we take the adab and akhlaq of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his companions, when he was talking sallallahu alayhi wasallam, all of them, they concentrated. And if none of them there, the people ask what he was talking about sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I want to hear it. Can you repeat it for me? Because you don't want to miss one word from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Today, even in the Jum'ah time, we're all busy with our phones. Even we announce it. We say, please, put your phone in your pocket. Put in silent. We announce it. It's still the people using it. Like, why they are here for? To listen? Or to just for give the fart? To pray and go home? What did you gain from the khutbah? While the best day of the isbu' is Friday. And it's the best hours that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you make dua, they accept it from you. But you come to the masjid, you ignore everything. The phone is interrupted your life. Example, very easy example. A brother call and he asked about me. And I say, you didn't call me for a couple of days. He said, I left my phone in the car. I locked it in the car and I went to work and I don't remember your number. Time? We lost our memories? All of us, we used to memorize the whole numbers of the phones. We all memorize it, 1, 2, 3. Today, go to the contact list. If you don't have the phone, you lost. Unless you memorize your phone number and your wife's number and your kid's number, that's the most. But we don't memorize the other people's number. The phone take our head away. Contact list. Google. How many of us open a tafsir book and read? None. Hey, everything in the phone. Fine, use it. But when they come to the time of the salah, for the house of Allah, in the house of Allah, to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, hey, you are there for that. Concentrate, because you don't want to lose anything. So our akhlaq need to be corrected. We don't need the curve of the Muslim going down. We need it high again. They said the Muslim was the most intelligent and smart people. Did you see that today? Do we see that today? No. We all depend on the others. We depend on the other foreigner, the people who's not saying La ilaha illallah. But they're dealing with us as a Muslims. But they're not Muslims. But we're dealing with each other with cheating and fighting. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be among the people who correct themselves and come back with good akhlaq as Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa sa'il mu'minin. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man walah. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, to be a good Muslims, we have to correct ourselves. We have to renew ourselves again. The man asking his scholar, his sheikh, are you prepare everything for the dunya? And he said to him, no. But I thought you're going to ask me another question. Did you prepare yourself for the akhirah? Because we are in a halaqah of the Quran, halaqah, we call it Islamic. So we ask a question for the akhirah, not the dunya. The dunya is for the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have the rizq written for you. You have the time of arrived, the time you will leave by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have no control of that. So you run as much as you can. You run everywhere. Whatever you gain, it's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it for you. No matter what. But for the akhirah, your akhlaq must be there. Yes. You are wealthy, but you're not healthy. You are poor, but you are healthy. But you are wealthy and healthy. But can you be poor and unhealthy? How we complete each other's? By the akhlaq. I have to look at you and you have to look at me. You have to help me and I have to help you. You have to see what I need and I have to see what you need. Islamic way. Today, our akhlaq lead us to very bad situation that even none of us at home, people allow themselves to come to your home and my home, talk to my wife or your wife with no permission. They just come directly and talk. Where is the akhlaq? Where is the akhlaq when the people come and visit you at home? Before he go inside the house, he already described what you have inside your home. What kind of eyes they have? Where is the eyes when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you come to the salah, the Prophet teach us, your eyes has to be in front of you, right in your spot. We used to go and knock the door and we go back 2-3 feet until somebody opened the door. Today they open, they knock the door and they stay there, waiting for someone to they open the door. No privacy. This is not our deen. This is not our Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning us. As he said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ وَإِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِتُكَمِّرْ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. You are there to increase the high level of moral, the akhlaq of the Islam, which we have it in the Sahaba at this time. They love each other. They care about each other. The woman, when she was in the high in the desert, she's blind. And Sayyidina Umar, he want to see who's helping this lady. Who is the one who has this akhlaq? Every time you go to help, when I help her, everything is there. Clean the house, the food is there. Until he watched from far. And he saw Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda. He is the one who is going there and help this woman. See the akhlaq? But before he became the Amir, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, he used to take care of the animal for the other ladies. When he became an Amir and a leader, they are said, oh, now Abu Bakr cannot help us anymore. He said, no, I will do my duty. Because this is the akhlaq of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda, the akhlaq of the Muslim, the moral of the Islam. Can we fix ourselves? Can we talk to ourselves before we leave our houses? Can we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to escape the shaitan from us? Can we talk to each other nicely? Can the family together get healed, not breaking apart? Can the husband and wife respect each other in front of the child? Can the child talk back to the nice to the parents? Can the parents talk nice to the child? Can they grab them to their sides? Can they take them to the masjid and learn something? You know where we're going down? When we take the kids away from the masjid. When we scare. When we scare that our kids join some bad people or good people. But there is an imam and a helper and support. Don't put them as to someone to babysit them. No. You need to put them and you follow up at home. You don't depend on the imam. Today the kids, 3-4 years, they don't know how to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. But do you know what is the iPad? Do you know what's EAAO? We learn it from them. But do you know Bismillah? They don't. Do you know Alhamdulillah? When they're sneezing, they say anything? Who's teaching them? No one. No one. Because they come to the masjid and they leave the masjid, no one follow up with them. Imam cannot do everything by himself. We have to help our child, our product. Islam will start from them. You have to build the Islam inside them. Alhamdulillah, you are Muslim, you are praying, you do your duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but care about your family too. We need to be together in the Jannah. We need to change ourselves. At work, at business, you cannot cheat, because the akhlaq of the Islam asking you to be the right person when you give some price. You have to give the price the right way. You don't cheat with the product because you are a Muslim. You don't cheat at your work because you are a Muslim. You don't cheat with your neighbor because you are a Muslim. Control your eyes from your neighbor because you are a Muslim. This is the akhlaq of the Islam. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that our akhlaq connected with the akhlaq of Muhammad and his companions. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let us among the people who taking care of themselves and come back to the akhlaq of the Islam. Allahumma ighfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat, al muslimina wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Allahumma ashfi mardana wa marda al muslimin. Allahumma wahhid sufufana ala la ilaha illa Allah. Allahumma ij'al akhlaqana bima turdika wa tardak. Allahumma ij'al akhlaqana bima turdika wa tardak ya Allah. Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, Ya Zal Jalal wal Ikram. اعفِ عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واشف مرضانا. اللهم اشف كل مريض. اللهم اجمعنا مع الصديقين والنبيين والشهداء في عليين. اللهم ارزقنا شربة ماء من يد رسولك الكريم لا نظمى بعدها أبدا. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة ونعيمها ونعوذ بك من النار وشرورها. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، رحمني ورحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة. Thank you.